Hello friends, welcome to this video on polynomials. Today, we will solve some questions based on algebraic identities. We have a total of 8 identities. By using these 8 identities, let us see how to find the factors and products of polynomials. So, let's start with our first question. Find the product using the appropriate identities. By looking at these 8 identities, can you tell which one can be used to solve this question? To find the answer to this, we will have to see to which identity this question resembles. That is, in which identity there is a sign of addition and subtraction between two terms. And that is identity 3. X square minus y square is equal to x plus y into x minus y. That is, 2x plus 1 by 2 into 2x minus 1 by 2 is equal to 2x square minus 1 by 2 to the power of 2. After solving this, we will get 4x square minus 1 by 4. Now, let's find the solution to another sub-question in a similar way. All identities are related to the addition or subtraction of two terms. If we write it in the form of 100 plus 7 into 100 plus 5, it will look like identity 4. X plus A into X plus B is equal to X square plus A plus B into X plus AB, where X is 100 and A and B are 7 and 5 respectively. So, 107 multiplied by 105 would be 100 square plus 7 plus 5 multiplied by 100 plus 7 multiplied by 5, which becomes 10,000 plus 1,200 plus 35. That is in total 11,235. Let's move to the next question. Find the factors of 9x square minus 6x plus 1 using the appropriate identities. Which identity does this look like? Can you answer? In such cases, pay attention only to the variable, that is x square minus x plus dash. Doesn't this look like identity 2? If we write it like this, 3x square minus 2 multiplied by 3x plus 1 square, then this becomes equal to 3x minus 1 to the power of 2. Let's go ahead and take the next question. Expand 2 by 3y minus 1 to the power of 3 using the appropriate identities. Here, we have to use the identity directly, where x is 2 by 3y and y is 1. Pause the video and try to solve it yourself. The solution will be somewhat like this. Now, write 1 by 2a minus 1 by 3b plus c whole square in an expanded form. Here, which identity will we use? Yes, identity 5. Here, x is 1 by 2a, y is minus 1 by 3b, and z is c. This is quite easy. Solve it yourself and see whether you are getting the right answer. Let's take the next question. Find the factors of x square plus 4y square plus 9z square minus 4xy plus 12yz minus 6xz. Once again, we will look only at the variable and all the identities and find out with which identity it resembles. If we write this expression only in terms of x, y, and z, then it will look somewhat like this. And now, we will write it as identity 5. Now, this will happen. which we will write in factor terms as follows. And now, let's take the last question of this session. The area of the given rectangle is as follows. 32x squared plus 6x minus 5. Give the possible expression of its length and breadth. Friends, the area of a rectangle is length multiplied by breadth. The area of a rectangle is a quadratic polynomial. After finding its factors, we have to substitute it with the length and the breadth. This means we have to find the factors of this polynomial. We will solve this polynomial 32x squared plus 6x minus 5 by splitting the middle term method. So 32 multiplied by minus 5 will be minus 160. Now, two numbers whose product is minus 160 and the sum is 6 are 16 and minus 10. Now, let's write it like this. 2x plus 1 and 16x minus 5 are the possible expressions of the length and breadth of this rectangle. So friends, that's all in today's session. In today's video, we learned to solve questions based on identities. See you in the next video with some more questions. Thank you.